It was one of the most horrific things that could ever happen to a person. And some of the things that I'm about to list, I want you to know that this was done for you and I. This was done so that we wouldn't have to go through it. This was done in an exchange for our sins. Jesus came to the earth knowing that he was going to die for you and I. He didn't come to the earth for ministry. He didn't come to the earth to heal people. He just did those things on his way to his destiny. And sometimes we get so confused because he healed the blinded eyes and he walked on water and he turned the water into wine, thinking that was his destiny. That was just a part of his journey. That was just a part of building the audience that was necessary. So when he looked at him, he said, "You tear this temple down. In 3 days, it's going to arise again." That was just along the way. But listen at what happened at the crucifixion. Once Jesus was arrested, he was taken from judgment hall to judgment hall. Ultimately, under the hands of Pontius Pilate. Pontius said, "You know what? I find no fault with this man. I wash my hands clear." Because see, what I need you to understand is just 7 days prior to the crucifixion, there was a palm situation where everybody was celebrating Jesus. Isn't it amazing how people will celebrate you as long as it's beneficial to them?
Jesus.
As long as it works in their favor.
Yes.
Rah, rah, yeah, yeah.
Come on.
I got your back. I got your support, whatever you need.
Absolutely.
But the moment you start to rub them the wrong way,
come on now.
Or the moment you're doing something that's conducive to them not feeling good any longer,
yes,
then they start to betray you. Those same
My
people
God.
That was saying, "Hosanna, Hosanna," was just 7 days later saying, "Crucify him."
Ooh.
Could you imagine how Jesus felt? He'd been on the earth for 3 years ministering to these people, healing people, setting them free, laying hands, demons being cast out. He didn't even have a place to lay his head. The Bible talks about the Son of Man not even having a place to lay his head. So he was so selfless and so much of a servant that he didn't even know where he was sleeping from day to day. But those same people that you did all of that for,
oh my God,
now 7 days later, they're saying, "Crucify him." Crucify him. In the crucifixion, you'll find that they beat him all night long. If you do the research, you'll find that one of the whips they use had bones at the end of the whip. And every time they would lay it on his back, it was designed for them to pull it and stretch it so that it would literally tear away the flesh on his back. The Bible says he was beat 39 stripes across his back. Jesus wanted you healed so much. This is where you have to become so tenacious about your healing and not just taking doctor's reports for what it is. You have to possess it. The Bible says he was wounded.
Come on.
For my transgressions. He was bruised for my iniquities. And the chastisement of my peace was upon him. And with his stripes, I am healed. A part of the salvation process is being able to embrace healing in its totality.
Amen.
It takes work. It takes effort. But when you realize that Jesus paid it all, somebody say all. He didn't pay just for you to have a good heavenly experience.
Yes.
He paid for you to have abundant life on earth.
Yes. Amen. Amen.
He paid that you, the Bible says, above all things, I wish that you prosper and be in good health, even as your soul prospers. Yes. So he didn't just pay for your eternity security.
Yes.
He paid for the active ability of the believer. believer to walk in abundance on a day-to-day basis. But Jesus now is at a place where there